yesterday with his Volcanion deck. A lot of people weren't really sure if Volcanion would show a big showing because of so many decks using Garbodor, and because it's so popular, no one really wants to lose against it. However, he still made it through, so I think it will be very, very great to see how it turns out.
Yeah, definitely. It looks like both these players are set up and ready to go, so we will start there with the handshake, and we are off at game one of day two of the Pokemon Trading Card Game European International Championships.
Yeah, one interesting thing to note is that Alexander Hill and Atar Riku actually played in the last round yesterday, and Atar was able to win. So let's see if Alex is able to turn it around this time. So he starts with his Unknown Firewall Letter. It's just a great card in these Vespiquen decks, because you can discard the Unknown, then draw a card. So when you play stuff like Level Ball, you can just take out an Unknown and then draw a card for it. Or you can put Unknowns on your bench, then play stuff like Anno, Professor Sycamore, and then draw cards afterwards. So you end up with like 9 hand cards. And also just cool having an Unknown on your bench, so when your opponent plays stuff like N41 or N42, you can just draw an extra card.
Yeah, it's sort of extra insurance that you can leave. If you just need it straight away, you can use it straight away. But if you don't, you can just leave it there, and then for when you need it later, you can just use it to draw cards. It's very versatile in that sense. And of course, because it is a Pokemon, once it goes in the discard pile, the Vespiquen's Be Revenge attack will do 10 extra damage. So it really pairs very nicely with Vespiquen.
Yeah, and here we see him just discarding Vespiquen, and I'm very interested to see how you even play this matchup. It seems very hard to beat, because you need your Vespiquens to deal a lot of damage, because Substriker don't do a lot of damage against Volcanion. As far as I know, Substriker deals more damage when your opponent has a resistance, which Volcanion does not have.
No, yeah, specifically resistance to fighting, it needs to be able to do the extra damage.
Yeah, so basically against every Pokemon that is weak to lightning, you deal even more damage. But in this matchup, I'm pretty sure Alexander will just discard all of his Striker to deal more damage with his Vespiquen. And then, of course, it's not very cool that he discards his one of his Vespiquen early on. Artan, knowing this, plays a Perilous City. The way that he only has 3 bench Pokemon seems kind of weird, because Volcanion needs a lot of bench Pokemon. But the other side says that grass Pokemon deal less damage. So with this, he can limit the damage output from Alex. But Artan's turn 1 was just attach an energy and then end the turn. So Alexander might actually be able to win the game now.
Yeah, all you really need is a way to retreat that Unown, and then perhaps, you know, a Vespiquen to evolve into an energy. And we haven't it doesn't have enough Pokemon discarded yet, but we do see there are 2 Unowns there. That would be another 2 Pokemon he could discard to do some extra damage. And we just discarded 2 off an Ultra Ball. So it seems quite likely that, given the way this deck normally sets up, that Alex will be able to do enough to get a knockout here. But it just depends mainly on whether he can retreat this Unown as a deactive.
Yeah, he also attached a Floatstone to his Trubbish, but did not evolve it. Because in this case, you just need to draw cards with your abilities to take the knockout on the Shaymin. Usually you try to have your Garbodor in play so the opponent can't use their setup or their Steam Up ability. But Alex now just needs to knock out the Shaymin, so his abilities are very important. And let's see if he's able to turn it off.
Yeah. The other thing about Garbodor in this matchup is that really Volcanion's Steam Up doesn't really do a huge amount in terms of, I mean, it can help a Volcanion Omni-X get an easier knockout, but the Volcanion EX will just be knocking out the Vespiquen anyway. And even then, he likely won't want to be attacking with the Volcanion EX, because then he's doing an unfavorable 2-for-1 price trade for an EX against an Omni-X.
Yeah, this is true. So I don't really think the odds are very great in Alex's favor. But he needed to know, going into a field of also not just Yveltal and Greninja, that he also needs to win against other decks. Yep. And I'm very interested to see.
I think Alexander's just drawn a float zone. He's counting the number of Pokemon in his discard pile. Does he have enough?
I do not know. There's a Perilous City in play. And yeah, he was able to get rid of the Perilous City with his Forest of Giant Plant.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's it!
Yeah.
That's it!
Good game. He was able to get rid of the Perilous City and, well, very fast game. Yeah, this actually reminded me of the last round we had yesterday. So, yeah, amazing. Very unfortunate for Atar. But now let's see if the matchup is really that good that you can still pull this off.
Yeah, so obviously Alex catching a bit of a lucky break there, thinking to himself, you know, give him a bit of a gift game there. So he's going to want, I guess, well, he'll be hoping that happens again, but it seems unlikely that this will happen 2 games in a row. So I think Alex will probably have to work a little bit harder for his win in game 2, but we'll have to wait and see.
Yeah, very interesting that Alex only plays 1 Forest of Giant Plants, and he happened to draw it in the moment he needed it. But I'm also pretty sure he still had a lot of stuff going on in his hand. He even had the Unknown on his bench, so he only needed to discard 1 additional Pokemon. So even without the forced the strand plans, I'm pretty sure he would have had the knockout if he just went for it. But of course it wasn't us straight away, and he wants to finish the game as fast as possible so they don't tie.
Yeah, exactly. So going into this game two matchup then, and it's obviously we didn't really see much of how the matchup interacts there, but Alex is definitely going to, regardless of the weakness, Alex is still going to want to focus on this at Vespaquen, because as you said, the Zeb Striker isn't going to be doing much. None of, apart from Shaymin, none of the opponent's Pokemon really have fighting resistance, so there's not really any benefit to attacking with Zeb Striker. Yeah. So it's mainly just, you know, fodder for discard to make Vespaquen do more damage.
Yeah, also I'm just looking at the screen, what's going on. You saw the judge talking to the players, and what he told them is just like that they shuffle in a way that they don't are maybe able to see the cards. So yeah, he was showing them like how you're supposed to shuffle. So there's just, they just want to make sure that nothing problematic is happening. And now you see the players spending extra attention to not shuffle in a way that they might see the cards. Of course, this would give you a warning at maybe a higher penalty, so no one wants to try to do this, and yeah.
Yeah, so just talking about the players specifically for a minute, we were, yesterday at round one, we had Tito Santoso, another very well-known Indonesian player, and here we have Atar. It's really cool, and this was a theme we saw recurring yesterday as well, to see all these players coming from all over the world to here to London to compete in this, you know, first international championships, and to see players, you know, coming from Japan, the Asia-Pacific region, the US, and the world over to compete. It's a wonderful thing to see.
Yeah, it's great. It kind of reminds you of a world championship, but here everyone can compete, so if you just want to come and play against the greatest players of the world, you don't need to get your world's invite. You can also just play an international championship. And I think this is a cool thing to have.
Yeah, I could not agree more. So we see that now just getting ready to set up. We can see that as the prizes go down. The prize is looking pretty okay for Alex. He's got one Vespaquen prize, one Dumbcolus.
Nothing too unusual here. And yes. So now Atar goes first. Here he has Volcanion, so most likely he won't get knocked out in the first turn by Alex. Of course, Alex would need a forest of giant plants to even have the chance of knocking it out. So very unlikely, but we saw he showed us that he might be able to do it. However, Atar opens his hand with an Ultra Ball, so this will take a bit longer than one turn.
Yeah, it will. We see that he's probably going to go straight for that. The Volcanion, of course, with the Power Heater attack, do 20 damage and allows you to attach two basic Fire Engine from your discard pile to one of each of your bench Pokemon. Just this really incredible attack. I mean, we've seen that the Oblivion Wing Yveltal has seen, you know, so much play and made that deck so strong for such a long time. And equally, you know, you do 10 less damage to go on the Volcanion compared to that, but you trade it off for an extra energy attachment, and it's just absolutely insane.
Yeah, it's amazing. The Volcanion deck is just good in general. I think this is why so many people play it and why it also shows as good as it is played. So you see, so the Yveltal deck, what I think from the metagame analysis, what you can see is how good decks actually are. So Yveltal was more in the top cut than it was actually played. So you can assume that it is better than it seems. But then you have decks like Mega Gardevoir, which were played a lot, and almost no one is in the top cut with it.
Yeah, it's strange, and I think a lot of this comes down to the Gardevoir deck. It falls quite foul to ability lock. It's very reliant on, you know, Hoopers and Dragonites to set up and to recover in the late game, and as soon as Gardevoir hits the field, Gardevoir can have a really hard time dealing with that, and I think that's probably why we haven't seen as much of it today.
Yeah, so in these matchups, of course, you have to think a lot about... I'm also curious how Atar Rico is dealing with Gardevoir, and if he actually goes for trying to knock it out in this matchup especially. Because Alex showed he has Trubbish, he has Floatstone, he has Gardevoir in his deck. So in theory, he is able to put an ability lock on Atar, which would prevent him from, like we already said, from using Steam Up and then taking knockouts on Vespiquen with his Volcanions. But of course, Volcanic Heat is also a big threat that you have to be aware of.
Yeah, just 130 damage. That pretty much knocks out anything in Alex's deck, as far as I'm aware. All the HP numbers in his deck are so low that a Volcanic Heat at any time would just be able to knock anything out.
Yeah, that's just true. And Alex will have a hard time, especially now that Atar was able to get rid of his Shaymin on the bench, which I think is a big factor in these kind of matchups, where it's hard to knock out your opponent's Pokemon. That you always have the option to play like Lysander Shaymin, and then grab some easy knockouts there. And especially if Alex decides to set up his Gardevoir, there isn't even a reason for Atar to play down Shaymin. So this will kind of deny him a big winning option. And I don't really think that Alex has the big advantage here. However, Atar has 40 minutes left to win all of these games.
Yeah. So this the whole you know, use a Hooper to grab a Shaymin and a couple of your EX attackers, and then Parallel City to discard the Shaymin and Hooper. It's a play we see so much happen in this standard format, and it's just so incredible because it essentially takes away the whole, you know, the drawback of using these, you know, Hooper to set up or, you know, Shaymin to draw cards is that they occupy space on your bench. But then you can just take that drawback away by just playing the Parallel City to your side, reducing your bench size to 3 and discarding them. It's incredible.
Yeah, and now we see Alex just retreating into Klefki. Yeah, this is... I think he was kind of forced into it because he needs his Vesequence, and Combi only has 40 HP, so even without Steam Up, it's still a one-hit knockout for Vulcanion because of the fire weakness. And now he's using his Steam Up ability, discarding one energy, so now he deals 40 damage and, 50 damage, and now it's already 80, so enough for the knockout on Klefki.
Yeah, so Alex there, a bit of an unfortunate spot for him, being forced to just pay a double colorless to retreat into Combi, because as you very rightly said, David, he really needs his Vesequence, and right now Alexander is like drawing absolutely nothing. We can see he just has to pass.
Yeah, this is a very sad game. The first one wasn't really exciting, and now the second one just Atara dominates completely. Yeah, he doesn't even need to Steam Up to take the knockout here. And he has an energy in his hand, and I'm thinking he's considering just attaching it, or just wait for the next turn so he can Power Heater for the knockout with using Steam Up. Because Alex has no way to get a Garbodor next turn, and here we see him just not attaching the energy. I really like this play, to keep it in his hand. And then when Alex evolves into Vespiquen, he can just take the knockout there with the Steam Up ability. But Alex just passes his turn again, and whoa, this is very one-sided.
Yeah, this is absolutely, and really, even at this point, if Alex draws out of it next turn, would it be like too little too late? It seems that at this point, yeah, it's really hard to see a way out for him. Of course, if he does end up losing another double colors energy, one important thing to note is that Alex is only playing double colors energy in his deck, but he also is playing 2 special charge. This makes a lot of sense, of course. If you're relying only on double colors to attack with, then you want to be able to use it as many times as possible. And in theory, 2 special charges, if played exactly the optimal time, will give you 8 double colors energy to use.
Yeah, that should be enough. Yeah, but now Alex is kind of out of winning options. Not against the Vulcanion decks, N is an incredibly weak, because they set up so many energies and play with Power Heater that it doesn't really matter that much. And now Alex just shuffles his whole Discard Pile back with Special Charge and Super Rod. And let's see if he has a supporter. Otherwise, I don't really think he can do anything at all.
He doesn't have a supporter, but his draw for turn was a Shaymin EX, so he'll be able to use that to draw cards, which is why he's burning cards out of his hand now, so he can draw more with said Shaymin.
Yeah, but it's very unlikely that he can take the knockout with Vulcan, especially after playing Super Rod for a few Pokemon that he had in his Discard Pile. But let's see, here we see an Acrobite, so at least something. 2 Acrobite, actually. Maybe he's able to get another supporter. Not yet. Oh, here's a Professor Sycamore.
There
it's
we
not,
go.
Not really... yeah, it won't really get him that far, I think, but let's see. At least he has a Vespiquen. And I see a few Pokemon in his hand, another Shaymin, so his turn definitely is not over yet.
Yeah, I was going to say, you say it won't get him that far, but given that he can, you know, just play more Unowns and discard them and draw cards, and he has the Shaymin, he has Ultra Ball to discard the Zebstriker in his hand, which he just doesn't want to use, and then, yeah, discard another N so he can reuse that later. I actually think he's in with a fairly decent shot. I mean, whether it will be enough is another matter entirely, but at this point he can just grab another Unown and then bench the Shaymin, and then after he's done that Shaymin, discard the 2 Unowns, and then, you know, maybe actually be able to pull off the KO. I mean, it's a lot to ask for, but anything can happen.
Yeah, now Alex really has to trade off what he's going to do here. It's very likely that Atar just has an energy, and then he can take 2 Vespiquens out just by using the Volcanic Heat from Vulcanion EX, because there are already 2 energies attached to each of the others, so only 1 energy will always give him the knockout. And even though he can't attack, he can also just retreat, and he has 3 prize cards left, so I can... It will be not that hard for him to win this game, and Alex really has to apply a lot of pressure. I think N is the key here, like just N for 1 at the end of the game. But without really dealing one-hit knockouts, I think Atar is in a better position.
Yeah, I definitely agree there. So we see that Shaymin coming down, he's going to draw himself, what looks to be 5 cards. We do see another Ultra Ball, so that's another means of him discarding Pokemon, and we do see that he did draw another Blitzel and a Garbodor, so... not been keeping exact track of how many he's discarded, but I mean, we know it's a lot already because we've seen he discarded one Ultra Ball early, discarded off of Sycamore. He can now search an Unown off of this to get,
yeah,
to get
but
more.
But he's going face-to-face with a Volcanion, which has 130 HP, and the Pearl City is in play, facing with the red side to him. So he needs 13 Pokemon in his discard pile, which is still a lot to ask for.
Yeah,
and
it is.
Unfortunately, we don't have any information about how many there are in the discard pile. And I don't think Alex has any unknowns left in his deck to use, because he just grabs the Klefki, which doesn't really do a lot in this situation. You can attach it and it discards itself at the end of the turn, so it's kind of like unknown.
But what you can do is attach it to the unknown and then use that.
Oh yeah, that's true. I completely forgot that one. So yeah, more Pokemon is discard pile. He can grab another Ultra Ball. Yeah, that was a very cool play. I didn't really think about it, but yeah, it's one thing you can do. Just attach it to unknown, discard it. Great. Yeah.
It's a really cool play. You can also, even if you have multiple Klefkis, you can say attach a Klefki to a Klefki and then do the same again to do like a chain of Klefki discards to get one Pokemon in the discard pile.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I really like how many options the Vespiquen got without Battle Compressor. We were used to Vespiquen decks being very fast and with just Battle Compressor discarding all the Pokemon. But now that Battle Compressor is gone, yeah, you don't have that many options. And Alex is just going crazy with discarding Pokemon in his first turn.
Yeah, we see two more unknowns, and he's going to count up now. So that's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's still not enough. Yeah, because the Parallel City means that it won't be enough. I think if the Parallel City wasn't there, he'd actually have exactly enough. But as it stands, he's going to be 20 short.
Yeah, so let's see if he has any other means to draw cards. No Shaman on the bench, no unknowns. So
and his bench is full now anyway.
That's it for this turn. And let's see. Yeah, 110 damage, so because of the Parallel City, this wasn't a knockout. So it was actually, it looked very close to being enough for the knockout. But now Atar, he just needed his team up, and like I already said, he didn't use his team up last turn to still have his energy in his hand. So now he can even take the knockout with Power Heater.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, he's just looking through to see, make sure he's not missing anything, but yeah, he goes to the steam up, so now, of course, the Power Heater attack will be doing 50 damage, doubling it for the Vespiquen's weakness makes it 100, that's a 90 HP knockout.
Yeah, and now let's see if Atar is still doing anything in this turn. You usually don't really want to play a lot of cards when you already have exactly what you need, but you need also make sure that there aren't a lot of like unusable cards in your deck.
Yeah,
so
because
you just want to get rid of some cards you won't need in the future, but you also don't want to use cards you need. So, for example, if you play N now, Tao would only have 3 hand cards, so that's very unlikely. But if you play Sycamore, he might discard a lot of important stuff in his hand. But he actually goes for Delinquent, and let's see how many hand cards Alex has. Unfortunately, no Pokemon to discard. It's also very funny when you just play Delinquent and your opponent is like, okay, discarding 3 Pokemon to deal more damage.
Yeah.
Now let's see if Atar plays his other Skyfield, his other Parallel City down, or if he decides not to.
It looks like he's deciding not to. I mean, you see he's putting the energy to the top, but okay, he's going to draw more with Shaman. See there, he draws another couple of energy and he presses Sycamore for next turn. So maybe he wants to just do another steam up, so because he obviously doesn't need this to get the knockout, but it means that he has another energy to attach a Power Heater, because of course the Power Heater lets you attach 2, and he does have the replacement Parallel City as well, so you can discard the Shaman that you just benched, which is really nice for him.
Yeah, and let's see if he discards the non-EX Volcanion. Now he can even play the uneven price game, which is a very important factor in these matchups, because he was able to discard all of his non-EX Pokemon in play, and now if the Volcanion gets knocked out, he still has 3 Pokemon EX to play with. And especially that he also got an energy card, he can even prepare 3 of his Volcanion that all of them one-hit knockout each of Alexander's Pokemon. And now he can just use Power Heater. He only needs 2 prize cards, so Alexander would seal the game up anyways, but now he has 2 Volcanion EX on the bench. And it will be very hard for Alex to win, but he has so much time that he can actually just try to maybe pull off something great with N.
Yeah, and it looks like that's what he's going to go for here. You see, playing very fast, evolve to Garbodor, touch the Floatstone, and goes Versus Seeker for the end and play that. So Atar there, I think, realizing last turn that, because, and this is exactly why he wanted to get rid of the useless cards, even if you are ahead, there is a fine balance to strike between being conservative and making sure that if you get end in this sort of situation, it doesn't end up coming back to bite you. At the same time, because Atar has so many attackers set up, it probably doesn't even matter in this circumstance, at least.
Yeah, so let's see if Alex has something in his sleeve that he might pull off, and then turn around this matchup, but I don't really think there is a lot to do here.
No, I agree completely. The nice thing that Alexander can do at least here is that he's guaranteed the knockout with a Sky Return.
Yeah, Sky Return knockout colors. Is pretty cool, but you can promote something that won't give Atari a prize card. And yeah, Atari just needs two knockouts, and he has two Pokemon that will always get the one-hit knockout here, so it's very unlucky. And also, the Sky Return is less valuable. Of course, you don't lose the double colors energy card, but you cannot use Steam setup again because he has Gardevoir with a tool in play.
Yeah, that's a point. It already is, so to say, a nice play. It's cool that you know you can do the Sky Return. Yeah, as you just said, because there's two other Shamans on the bench already. You can't reuse them because the Garbodor's out in play, and we see there a trainer spell from Atar versus.
Yeah, maybe he gets even a Lysander that would win him the game immediately, but he doesn't have it. But it doesn't really matter at this point, I think. When he takes energy to the active Volcano, there's even less Alex can really do. So and then he can just retreat. Use Volcanic Heat, the same Volcanion can't attack again, but then he has two Volcanions that are ready to attack anyways next turn.
Yeah, it's really not looking good for Alexander here, and I imagine that it won't be too long before we go find ourselves going into a game three as Atar just plays the Sycamore, draws his seven, and we'll see what he gets off of this. Looks like this will be a Fire Energy, so yeah, next turn he can just make it so earn a Max Elixir as well. Just to put four energy onto a Volcanion, which seems a little bit unnecessary, but I guess, again, it thins out the deck. It's cards you don't really need.
I was wondering why he didn't retreat first and then play the Max Elixir, because the active one can't attack anyways, and I don't really see any reasoning behind using a fourth energy to Volcanion, other than maybe retreating stuff, but he won't attack twice with the same Volcanion anyways, but let's see how this game evolves.
I guess it saves a couple of seconds between retreating, but then he's going to retreat to attack anyway, so no, it doesn't even do that. And yeah, we see that a knockout on the Blitzel, so Atar is going to go down to one prize card left. What does Alex draw? I don't even know
what he can do. I was like thinking maybe the Blitzel has like Thunder Wave for 10 for heads to paralyze your opponent and then just hope your opponent decks out. That was... But the Blitzel doesn't even have this attack, so unfortunately, I don't really see anything Alex can do here.
Yeah, no, and he's just looking for you to make sure he's not missing anything. I mean, you know, obviously, we could miss something here. We don't necessarily get to see absolutely everything that's going on with the discard piles and such, but no, it looks like Alexander is going to be content with doing that and then just hope that he, you know, there's no means of, yeah, and Alex realizes
yeah,
nothing
he can
do.
Atar just says, like, yeah, I will retreat and attack, so the game is over. It's 1-1 now. Very interesting. But... yeah, Atar really had the good thing here going on. Alex first turn didn't look great. He kind of looked like a comeback, but it was already too late for him. So, yeah, that won't be happening. Maybe the third game, now Alex can also go first. So setting up turn two Garbodor might be a very important factor. And yeah, but let's see how the hand cards of the players turn out.
Yeah, we'll just have to wait and see there. Although, it is like saying in game one, the Garbodor does obviously stop the steam up, which means that the non-EX Volcanion can't get a one-hit knockout with the Power Heater. But at the same time, if you're not getting a one-hit knockout, it doesn't even matter too much because, you know, you just attach energies to stuff and you can just trade really efficiently because of the weakness and the fact that, you know, the Volcanion EX has such a insurmountable amount of HP to knock out with the Vespuca, and it's just really, really hard for Alex to actually pull it off.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah, we saw him in the first game, but that wasn't really something amazing. It was just happened. It happens all the time, and no matter the matchup.
No.
Sometimes one player just only has one Pokemon, doesn't draw really well. But this is the reason why you play three games, so this won't kick you out of like a tournament or something.
So, as we see there.
Yeah, what do you think about the Volcanion deck in general?
I think that one of the reasons why it's so popular is that its game plan is very simple. You know, you just want to early on lead with a non-EX Volcanion to do Power Heater to attach to your EXs and then take big knockouts of your EXs and steam up. It's a very easy game plan to sort of pick up and play. The deck's very consistent. There's, you know, not much going on. Normally it just plays, you know, the Volcanion EX, the non-EX Volcanion and Shamans, and maybe a Hooper obviously to grab the Volcanion EXs. As It is a very good, consistent tournament-winning or at least tournament-well-performing deck to pick up. I think that's part of the reason why we see it so much.
Yeah, and I think they both had like different things in mind. When you play Volcanion, there is not really a lot of countering going on. There is nothing that you just win against because your deck has the advantage. It's just very consistent. You win against a lot of decks just by being Volcania and dealing a lot of damage. You can one it knock out Mega Pokemon fairly easy as long as they don't have a Garbodor in play. And you can also just Lysander Garbodor with a Fighting Fury, but you have so much HP. So Volcanion is just a very consistent deck in general. That's also, like I already said, not that complicated to play because you only have like two options, which is Power Heater or the Volcanic Heat attack. And of course, you have a very fixed strategy, which is first I attach a lot of energies, and then later on I can use my Volcanion EX to attack. But Alex's deck is more like he's trying to counter good decks. So he knows he will win against Yveltal, he will win against Greninja, and against other decks he has a decent shot. So Volcanion might not be one of the decks he considered winning against, but at a lot of tournaments you don't really, it's not really that important to win against all kind of decks. So yeah, you just need to win against the right decks.
Yeah, exactly. But we are off here with game three. Alex obviously will be going first. You see he gets a pretty decent start there. He's got two float zones and two trubbishes. I bet Atara is not going to be happy to see that. And another Shaman setup after having already done one. An Acrobike as well. You're going to be able to discard that Klefki. There's a lot of really nice things going on here already, and he's doing that combo play we talked about earlier.
Yeah, amazing.
So Wunderlock onto the Feral Letter, Unknown, and Feral Letter to draw a card. Incredible.
Yeah, now he plays Acrobike, another Floatstone, might be going to Shaman or something else. But again, I don't really think his hand is too great. He just passes turn with a Blitzel on his bench, so no combi for him. And again, this is not the optimal start that you can have. Yeah. And as long as Atar gets a few energy cards in play, I think he will have the advantage again.
Yeah. It's weird as well, because we saw that Alex's start was so fast. You know, he played two Shamans, drew a ton of cards, but still no supporter and no combi. It shows that sometimes, even when you have what looks to be a really explosive start, it doesn't really surmount to what you need.
Yeah, I mean, you draw a lot of cards, but you don't draw the cards that you want to have.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah, it will be I don't really think that this game will be too exciting. Of course, Alex has a lot of comeback options, but for these comeback options, he needs his Vespic Vince to apply pressure, dealing damage. I'm not entirely sure right now how much damage the striker deals without the bonus from the attack. I think it's like 60 damage, but that's not even enough for a 2-hit knockout, so he will definitely need some combis in the next future.
Yeah, he will. I see that Atar going to play an Ultra Ball, grab himself the Hooper EX from the deck, use that to search out two more Volcanion EXs, so he now has got the three that it will be more than enough to see him through the rest of this matchup. You see there, him opting not to grab the Shaman. That tells me that he already has a supporter in hand. Obviously, you don't want to bench a Shaman if you don't need to, because then it's just something that if you don't see a Paralysis later, you can't discard it, and then that's a means for Alex to come back into this game by taking a couple of easy prizes. But he's not done that, so he's just grabbed the two Volcanions, and yeah, we'll probably see a Sycamore or an N after this.
Yeah, now he also got one of his Max Elixir. Max Elixir is actually a pretty nice card in Volcanion, because he needs so many energies to attack, and because you always need to use Steam Up, you need to play a lot of energies anyways. So then you can just add a few of the Max Elixir to just attach them without using an attack.
Yeah. And as we see there, so the reason why he didn't grab a Shaman was because he already had one in his hand, so he's benching that to draw some more cards. And yeah, that last card in his hand was Versus Seeker, so he didn't have the option to not play Shaman, which is unfortunate for him. But we see there a lot of Max Elixirs drawn for Atar there, and it looks like a Fire Energy as well, but not really anything he can use to draw further, which is a little bit awkward.
Yeah, I mean, it looks kind of like Alex for his turn, which was like, yeah, it starts good, Ultra Ball, he has Hooper, Ultra Ball, Shaman, and then looks at his hand and is like, well, why do I have this hand? It's not supposed to be like this. He also did not get any energy from his Max Elixir here. I think he had two in his hand and also one additional energy. Will be exciting to see if he attacks just with Power Heater to just deal some damage, because he's still kind of safe in this position. But yep, also he needs to fear that Alex just evolves and then he can't use Steam Up anymore. But here we see another Max Elixir actually attaching to the Volcanion on the bench. One Steam Up, an Energy Retrieval.
So you can just use the Steam Up. Oh, you know, he's opted to attach it this time. And yeah, oh, okay, he did draw
an N.
Yeah, so I didn't see that he actually drawn a supporter. That must have been at the back of his hand, but he has actually drawn. So he'll be able to advance himself a little bit more here. And yeah, using the Energy Retrieval quite cleverly, so it meant that he only had one energy in hand, but you can use that to Steam Up, use the Energy Retrieval to pick it back up, and then attach it so you actually had an energy guarantee to attack with. And
yeah,
now, of course, all he needs to do is draw into one more Fire Energy, and he can Steam Up again and actually get the knockout on the Trubbish.
Yes, this is true. And also the energy retrievers are kind of weird in this deck. You play a lot of energies, but it's still not enough. Altara plays one Pokemon, one Fisherman, and three energy retrieval. But without Garbodor, you don't really have a lot of energies in your discard pile anyways. And if you have, you want to use power heaters. So I think just getting rid of your energy retrievers early on is actually pretty good in this matchup.
Yeah, yeah, I agree. And we see that Altara has played all four of his max elixirs in one turn. You've just seen his player's fourth one there, and that one is a hit. So he'll be able to use that to attach to the Volcanion EX. And now, with the power heater attack, because he obviously just did another, he has another fire engine in his hand, so he'll be able to steam up again. He'll actually be able to charge up his bench Volcanion EX in one turn, which is just ridiculous.
This is amazing. He's going really, really hot with this deck right now. Just attaching a lot of fire energies to his Volcanions, using the steam up, and now, again, he takes a very fast lead in this game. And Alex really needs to draw good again.
I see what he did there, Volcanion, running hot.
Yeah, so Unknown, just drawing two cards with two Unknowns. Now he got a combi, at least something. He also got a Vespiquen, but he decides to discard it just to have more bench, more Pokemon in this good pile. We saw last game, he did not manage to knock out the Volcanion non-EX, but now this one has a Fighting Through Bud, so it's even harder, especially the Forest of Giant Plant, the one Forest of Giant Plant X plays. It's in his press cards, so he cannot even, even if he draws perfectly, he cannot attack this turn with Vespiquen. So he would need to use the Striker to hit a bit of damage, but then the Volcanion still has 110 HP left. So it's kind of problematic, but Alex at least has something to do here.
He does, and it might even be a good argument to maybe go for the Sky Return instead, because that way, if he has a double colors in his hand, he can attach to the Shaman, do Sky Return for 30, take a little bit of chip damage on that Volcanion, and take away just an easy KO option for Altara to really go ahead in the prize trade. But then after he wanted to follow that up with a Vespiquen, he'd need more Pokemon in the discard pile. So it's you could argue it either way, I guess. But we see there, he doesn't have the double colors anyway, so he's going to draw with the Sycamore.
Yeah, it really depends on the hand he's drawn. Like I already said, you don't want to lose your double colors energy cards. There are only four in the stack. So Sky Return gives you like one additional Pokemon and one additional double colorless energy card. But if you really need to just try to get the maximum damage output, I actually think that you just have to use the Striker. But of course, it's not really that great. And also if you use Sky Return, then put the Striker active. And then the Striker gets discarded by just because it's knocked out. That's also a lot more damage. So I can see both place here making sense, but actually thinking about it, Sky Return might be the better one.
Yeah, but it looks like he won't have the option to do either, because I don't think I saw him draw a double colors off that.
Yeah, I didn't saw it too. Also, his third Shaman EX is in the prize cards. A lot of unfortunate prize cards for Alex, also just a lot of Pokemon in general, four of them. So he will be limited a lot in this game.
Yeah, it's also a bit of bad news for him, and I mean, especially, he can't really afford to have these awkward things prized, because he needs these to actually take the edge back in his matchup. Because as it stands, Altara's just setting up beautifully, and it's going to be a struggle for Alex to make a comeback.
Yeah, he wasn't even able to do anything, so he just ended his turn with Galvador active. So Altara, usually I would say in theory he could play another Max Elixir and attach it to one of his Volcanions, but we know there is no Max Elixir left, so he would need a switch card, which is Escape Rope. He only has Escape Ropes and Floatstones to switch the active Pokemon. There is already Fighting Fubert to the active one, so no way for him to attack with more than 20 damage this turn. So Alex Hill, you have to consider that you already played against Altara in a best of three match, so he should know that there is no switch in his deck, so he could just very smart, he knows there is no way my opponent can deal so much damage now, so I can just have Garbodor active and then let it eat some damage, and then I can retreat it to be the safe state. So that was a pretty good play by Alex.
Yeah, it's very clever. Sometimes you see someone doing something like that, leaving a Garbodor active, and you think, oh, but no, but it could get knocked out, right? So why do we take that risk? But then Alex, being the great player he is, realizing that it isn't a risk and that he can afford to do that because, as you very rightly said, it's going to be extremely hard for Altara to even take that knockout by attaching energy to a bench one and retreating. So
no, but in this situation, this actually is impossible because he has zero Max Elixirs left in his deck. All of them are in the discard pile, and he has no switching option.
Oh, does he not play Escape Rope?
He plays Escape Rope, but then the Garbodor goes to the bench again. So if there is escape rope, Alex can just put the Zip Striker active. So the Garbodor is really safe in this position here.
Yeah, okay, yeah, this makes sense. Yeah, he doesn't play like a regular Switch, obviously.
Yeah, the only option to knock out the Garbodor would be escape rope and then Lysander. But if he has these two, it didn't really matter that the Garbodor was active at the beginning of the turn anyways. So a really good play. It didn't really look like a big one, but these kind of stuff is what brings him to the top 32 of the best players in
Europe. Yeah, specifically 8-1 as well, so right at the top of that top 32
as
well.
Yeah, this is true. They are like the first and second seed or something like in this area.
Yeah, this is literally table 2 before you obviously picked it out. So, yeah, Alex having another look through here, just thinking about what he can do. It seems like he's really struggling to think of something right now. He does have a double colorless now, but okay, he's actually opting to go with the Zeb Striker. And we are going to see,
it's only 50 damage, very unfortunate.
Crashing bolts there, you see there the attack for a double colorless energy, it does 50 damage, and then if your opponent's active Pokemon has fighting resistance, this attack does 60 more damage. As David said earlier, most Pokemon with fighting resistance tend to be lightning weak, so that means you're doing 110, double for weakness, 220, which pretty much knocks out all the big lightning weak Pokemon like Yveltal EX, if you're fighting Fury Belt, Mega Rayquaza, all of them.
Yeah, exactly. So the reason why people, there used to be decks that played Raichu, from generations which were double colorless, these 10 for each of your bench Pokemon. But if you have a full bench without Skyfield, it doesn't even knock out Yveltal anymore with one hit, because Fighting Fury Belt gives them 210 HP. So you really need Zip Striker to get the one hit knockout, because that's 220. But like you can see here, Raichu, in other matchups, Raichu is more versatile, which is the reason why it used to be more popular. But of course, when you play an anti-Yveltal deck, you should be able to knock out Yveltal.
Yeah, and again, it's a call that Alex made on the basis of, right, I've seen that these Yveltal Garbodor variants have been so popular that it just makes more sense to, if I just think about what I'm going to play over the course of a tournament, statistically, this play makes the most sense, and that's why he's opted to go for it.
Yeah, this is true. So, yeah, very unfortunately, wasn't able to deal a lot of damage with Vespiquen. And our tower again, he can just attach a lot of energies from his hand. Of course, he can't use Steam Up anymore, and he also can't use any Max Elixirs, so Alex can really calculate a lot for what is going to happen during this game. And even though it didn't really look great for him, now he might be able to turn it off. However, Atar, I think still has the advantage.
Yeah, I definitely agree there. So Atar's just thinking about it. He has drawn the escape rope, so obviously if he plays it at this point, then Alexander would be forced to switch the Zeb Striker into something else, and really, he can maybe switch into a Shaymin, but then obviously that just gets knocked out by a Volcanic Heat.
Well, the thing is, it might be that Atar has no energy in hand. And now this is a big bait escape rope.
This absolutely
because
is.
Because if Alex puts any Pokemon which is not combi active, he knows it will be knocked. There is a high chance it will be knocked out by Volcanion EX. But if Atar knows, well, it doesn't make sense to put anything but the combi active, and I don't have any energy card, then I might get away with it. So, and Alex also might trade off, like, well, maybe he doesn't even have the energy. And now, here we see, just putting Gardevoir active. So let's see if Atar has an energy to take the knockout here, or
no,
not.
He doesn't.
Yeah, he does not have the energy. So, great. That was, like, some poker stuff going on here.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah, that's.
And he just ends his turn. So Alex is, like, looking at his, oh, you didn't have the energy, right? Oh, yeah. Big relief.
Yeah.
And I think this was a very great escape rope. And this is the reason why I already talked about this, that Switch and escape rope are very similar, but escape rope is just so much better at high-level play, because it allows you as a player to do these very great turns, but also your opponent might trick you out because they can switch their Pokemon.
Yeah, some top-level mind games from Atar there, and Alexander being able to see through it and realize that Atar did not have the energy and just promote the Garbodor, and Atar just thinking, well, you got me, your turn.
Yeah, it also could be that Alex didn't really think about the energy stuff, and Garbodor was actually the Pokemon that he felt most comfortable with discarding. But of course, it turned out to be the perfect play here anyways.
Yes, absolutely. So we see there that the end being played, Alexander's going to be able to get himself a full hand of 6.
Now Tal is looking at his hand, oh, here is the fire energy.
Yeah, a little bit late.
And yeah, let's see. The only problem now is that, again, Volcanion active, which has a lot of HP. And Altar has 3 Pokemon on his bench, which all can take out any Pokemon with one hit for just an additional energy card. Even the non-EX Volcanion deals 100 damage for 3 fire energy with a fighting fury barrier, but it's 110. So even enough to knock out a Shaymin EX.
Yeah, of course, that steam artillery attack is something you don't always see being used, but you know it is pretty good as well because yeah, just doing 100 damage on a non-EX with 170 HP with a fighting fury belt, it works out. And like I said, enough to knock out a Shaymin, which is just a easy 2 prizes right there.
Yeah, and here we see another energy attached by Alex, but this time he is using Vespiquen's attack. Let's see how many Pokemon are in this discard pile. I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, something. So 80 damage. 90 damage, actually. So because of the Paralysity, of course, you only deal 10 damage for each Pokemon in your discard pile, yep, instead of the plus 20 that you usually get. And now Tower is thinking about, does he attack with the Volcanion EX? Or with the non-EX Volcanion, but I think he decides to go for the non-EX one since he attached energy here. Both are able to take the knockout anyways. But I think I personally would have preferred the other Volcanion because it has a Float Stone, so you can kind of outplay your Volcanic Heat effect that you cannot attack by attaching the energy there first and retreating into the non-EX Volcanion, then you can use the attack again. But here he just has this non-EX Volcanion that Alex don't really want to knock out because he just needs to take out 3 Volcanion to win the game, 3 Volcanion EX to win out the game, or he can knock out 3 Volcanion EX and the non-EX Volcanion, so it seems kind of problematic here, so which is why people like to use this, like only one non-EX Pokemon than just Pokemon.
Yeah, it's what we talked about earlier with the 7 prize game. What we talk about when we refer to that is the fact that if you have, say, you know, a non-EX out and that gets knocked out, your opponent takes 1 prize card, then if you only have EXs left, they're forced to do like the equivalent work of taking 7 prize cards, even though they only need to take 6 to win the game. So that non-EX that they knocked out essentially becomes an almost worthless knockout, and it's them just like wasting time, which is obviously, if it's just me, puts the person who managed to do that in a great situation.
Yeah, exactly. It's like wasting time and also wasting resources to play around it. So there's always a disadvantage for the player not having the 7 prize games. So this is I think the easiest to explain high level play that you can do, just these non-EX Pokemon in the right time. Of course it's not that easy with Volcanion, but of course when you start with the non-EX Volcanion, then just get 3 on your bench with Paracity in deck, you can do this. A lot of Volcanions also played stuff like Skyfield or Scorched Earth, but I really like Paralysity just to get rid of your bench Pokemon to do this 7 prize stuff.
Yeah. And as we see there, Alex playing another Ultra Ball, discarding a Pokemon Ranger, and it was Garbodor, that was it. But opting not to get anything from his deck right now. It'll be interesting to see how much he actually has in his discard. I'm fairly sure with the amount he's discarded now that he will be able to do enough to take the knockout on this Volcanion in the active. But I think seeing Atar just having a double check, he was just counting up, and he's seems to be an... Oh, did he forget about the Parallel City?
Well, it was 90 damage last turn, so it might not even be enough for the knockout.
Oh dear.
He didn't draw a prize card yet, so it's not a big deal. They're just recounting it. Unfortunately, we don't know.
Yeah.
We can't touch the physical deck from here. But we will see if it is enough. But if there are 9 Pokemon in the discard pile, he would only deal 90 damage, so that's 140, not enough. But it seems like... Yeah, it seems like here we have the knockout, so just barely enough because of Paralysity.
Yeah, but even then, it's not as if the knockout is that impactful, because as we talked about, it's the non-EX, and now there's only EXs left on Atar's side, so yeah, 7 prize game is
also,
go.
Also, Alex got his Shaymin EX from the prize cards, which won't really help him a lot.
No, exactly.
So, well, yeah, 2 energies left for Atar, but now at least because of the, he cannot use Power Heater. So he needs to draw his energy cards to use Volcanic Heat, so he kind of opens up the option for him to just use... Alex now has the option to play N, and then if Atar doesn't draw energy cards, he can still win the game. This is what I wanted to say. But as long as Atar now has only 1 energy left, we saw him grabbing a Volcanion from his deck with Ultra Ball. I think he just discarded it for Professor Sycamore. I wanted to say that it is kind of weird that he puts it on his bench, but he just discarded it, of course.
Yeah, he was just using it to thin the deck to make it more likely to draw the energy, which he has done, so yeah, he will exactly. be able to do Volcanic Heat this turn, which is obviously great.
Knowing that your opponent's only last chance to win the game is to play N, and you don't draw the energy cards, you want to get rid of as many deck cards as you want. Here he drew another Volcanion, Noniax, which he just put on his bench with a Floatstone, just again, so when your opponent plays N, he can just... He will not draw the Volcanion Onyx, he will not draw the Floatstone. And it's still very unlikely that Alexander will play Lysander for the non-Onyx Volcanion. So as long as it has a Floatstone, it will not attack. It still is having price game, it's still up. But of course, it's not like, you don't have to really put yourself into this position where you have to do this. Don't play down any non-Onyx Pokemon. In these kind of situations, you can play a lot around. And now Alex plays Lysander for Volcanion. I actually see a little problem here. Because he is not able to take the knockout here, and he kind of resets Volcanic Heat.
Oh, but then
and
again,
Atar just has the Versus Seeker for Lysander. Volcanic Heat taking out the Shaman, drawing his last two prize cards, and advancing another round. Now he is 9-1 for top 32, and that's a lot of match points, and I think he will have an easy time just using intentionally ties to go into the top 8. So I think that was a pretty nice game, and yeah.
Yeah, Atar putting himself in a very nice position there. Congratulations to him. Got a few more rounds to go still, but you know, at this point in time...
Yeah, we will have an interview with Atar, but this time he won't come backstage to us. We actually have James Hart himself interviewing, so we'll go to a short break and stay tuned.
Yeah, yeah.
Before we go...